touch this topic of thoughtlessness, now I heard you talk on the fact that we have a very, very cynical world because it doesn't think enough. You said that if at all we had first, you crossed that first layer of thinking, exhausted fully, before even endeavor for that stage called thoughtlessness, you can't begin from there. And that set me thinking that I'm trying to get as much thoughtlessness and peace, but have I really thought about things enough?
Yes.
And that made me a little disbalanced in a way. In a way that it made me really think that maybe you already have so many beliefs, you really are not thinking hard enough, and that's what he's indicating. So don't try for thoughtlessness yet. But I love thoughtlessness. I love it so much that I crave for it in my attempts through meditation or right now, for example, I'm talking, I'm not thinking anything. But the talk of yours made me go back and really analyze, is that the right endeavor even?
It cannot be an endeavor. The key word is fully. When I say that you must think fully, the key word is fully. Key word is not think. I'm saying think fully. The accent, the stress is on fully, not on think. When I'm saying think fully, I do not mean think more and more. I mean think from a point of fullness. I do not mean think continuously. That will just load the mind. I'm saying think fearlessly. And when thought is fearless, when thought is arising, not from a need to secure yourself, then thought serves its function, its material function, and disappears. And thought does have a material function. Who can deny that? You need thought to put a flyover together. You need thought to have this camera, this cloth, this building, or
This session itself.
this session itself. They cannot happen without thought. But where is that thought coming from? Is that thought coming from a need to secure myself? If that is coming from there, then the thought will be unending. But if the thought is coming from completeness, then the thought will not contribute to completeness. Then the thought is not really needed. It is just an instrument. A while back I said a slave. It does not serve a critical or central function. The critical or central is already secure. The thought is now serving only a secondary, even a tertiary function. So even without thought, you are all right. Now thought can go away. Are you getting it? Thoughtlessness does not mean that you don't have to think. Thoughtlessness means that you don't have to take thought seriously. That thought does not become your backbone. That you do not become someone who is called a thinker. Now thought is ancillary in your scheme of things. So at times you think and it is okay. At times you are not thinking, it is still okay. Sometimes you must think a lot, and that is fine. Sometimes thought gets its objectives. Sometimes thought will not get its objectives, and both are fine. Now thought is not having great importance. That is living in thoughtlessness. Thought,
it's a slave.
It's a slave. Sometimes you use it, sometimes you don't use it. If you use it, nice. You don't use it, nice. With most of us, thought is our identity. Thought is our very soul. Now that is a problem. That is even evil.